You schooled me to the game. The man who educated me on the live scene and everything else that's good with that. DJ Diffinite, Brent Shifty Pihi, my man, the other half of the mighty Funky North.
Kia ora, ngā mihi nui ki a koutou, ngā kai whakarongo I tēnei wā. Kia ora, bro.
Good How to be you, here. Brother, bro? It's been a minute since I've seen you.
How are you?
It's been a minute, man. Yep. But thank you for coming in today.
My pleasure.
So what you been up to?
What I've been up to? Oh, man, I've had a big year, actually. I've been travelling and working and making music and, you know, just doing what I do. But travel's been a big part of this year, so I've been overseas and going overseas again in October. So, yeah, it's all on and, you know, living up in Kaikohe here in the far north and loving it. All good.
Yes, yes. And that's all outside of what you do as a musician too, right?
Yeah, hard out. In fact, I've got to be honest, music's had to take a wee bit of a backseat for the large part this year with work and teaching and travelling. I was in Vietnam and Laos and Thailand and doing some teaching over there, and I'm back in Indonesia in October with a group of New Zealand teachers, so my mahi has been taking me places this year. It's been one of those years.
Sweet.
Yeah.
Ah, man. I'm actually quite unprepared, because I'm actually just excited to see you get down and do your thing, because this is the first time that I've actually had a live DJ, like a, you know, a disc jockey, not just the guy who just plays music like myself. This is the first time that I've had an actual DJ come in and keen to do a live set. So oh, I'm really hyped, man.
Well, I got to admit, I've fallen back in love with DJing. In fact, with my vinyl, and I've been making mixes with my records and just love it. I mean, we're in a digital age, right? Everything's screens, computers, phones, and I'm down with all that. You know, times change, but there's something real satisfying about just playing records. No screens, no sync button.
Yeah.
Just records and music, and it's, yeah, I've been really enjoying that. That said, I'm using my little digital setup.
I was just about to say.
I guess for convenience's sake, and digital's got its place, so this has enabled me to come here and play some tunes, so I'm stoked about it. I'm a DJ because I'm a fan of music. I didn't get into DJing to win battles or be the best DJ or even do gigs. I got into it because I'm a fan of music. That's all it is.
Yeah, and you also come from a different time of DJing as well.
Are you calling me old?
We'll say classic.
Truth is, I come from a different era of hip-hop, that's for sure.
Yeah.
And music in general, but, two turntables and a microphone, that's what I understood hip-hop to be, so I'll run with that. That's a classic form, you know? I mean, it's not a form that's taken for granted anymore, that's for sure. And that's, like I say, I'm not against technology, I'm not against evolution, but, you know, it'd be like trying to make a rock band without a guitar, you know?
Yeah.
How do you do it?
Yeah, exactly.
I'm old. I'm showing my age, man. I love hip-hop. I love classic hip-hop. You know, when you talk about hip-hop to me, you're talking sort of late 80s into the 90s primarily. But, you know, good music can be made at any place and time, so it's all good. I'm not hating on anyone.
Speaking about hip-hop, what is your opinion, if you have one, on today's hip-hop? What is considered hip-hop today?
Well, my first disclaimer is that I don't perhaps have a very informed opinion, to be honest.
Mm-hmm.
I try. That said, I don't like to just keep going back to the same old, because, like I just said before, good music is being made every day. So I give everything a listen and whatever crosses my radar anyway. And, you know, I'm sure there's some really good stuff. I respect anybody that's doing it well. Whether I like it or not is a whole different story. But I respect anybody who's passionate. People like Kendrick Lamar, you know, on the international scene, they're really good at what they do. And I don't know about those mumble dudes though, man. Give me a break.
Yeah, I mean,
change it up, have different beats, talk about different things, but it should be based on skills, you know?
Yeah.
That's just my opinion. But if you mumble and, you know, any Muppet can mumble, but, yeah, I guess I'm hating on that. But nah.
Yeah. Like me. You are also a father, and you have teenage children.
Correct.
Do they listen to today's hip-hop, like all what we both would call mumble rappers?
Well, my own children might listen to a bit of it here and there, but they're not, I wouldn't say that they're into it. But more importantly than my own children, I'm around teenagers every day because I teach in high school, you know?
Yeah.
So
yeah.
There's two different schools. There's the ones who want to keep up with whatever's trendy at the time, and they'll listen to whatever's cool at the time, whatever's getting the most clicks or plays or whatever, most video watches. But there's this core group within that age group, and I'm talking 15 to 20 year olds basically, who love old school rap, like they love classic rap, and they don't like the new stuff. So there's no rules about it anymore, that's for sure. You know, there's young dudes who fully are into classic golden era 90s boom bap. And, you know, and within that, they like the Tupacs and the Snoop Dogs, the ones who were there before, were there at that time and still around now. Oh, not Tupac, but Snoop Dogg. You know, they like that kind of era, but they also like the less known ones. There's a young boy at my school. He's right into Hieroglyphics, Del the Funky Homosapien. I mean, the fact that he even knows
who
stuff
they are, exactly,
is pretty impressive. But he's a big fan of Hiero. So, you know, just when you think you've got them all worked out, someone will come along and blow you away like that. So it's pretty cool.
That's crazy.
It is.
So apart from being a DJ,
yeah.
For those who do not know, you're also a part of a duo, Diffinit and Bling, but that's hip-hop. Yeah. You also make music outside of hip-hop.
It's true.
With your band, like, all the bands that you've been with.
Yeah. Well, my start in music came about through rock music because, you know, I'm 41 years old, so I was a teenager in my early 20s in the 90s, so I got right into live music and playing guitar initially, and then I got into bass and was playing in rock bands, hardcore bands, metal bands, you name it, alternative rock at the time. And that was actually the roots of my involvement in music. And then, you know, maybe going back to around the year 2000 now, I got into DJing, and then that led me into producing beats and hip-hop. I was always a fan of hip-hop, but making hip-hop, that's a relatively secondary thing for me in the timeline. But yeah, man, I'm just into good music. Like, I don't really care about genre that much. A lot of people, they pledge allegiance to the genre, and that was just never me.
Yeah.
I love good music, don't get me wrong. I love hip-hop, but I equally love metal, and I equally love pop songwriting, good pop songwriting. I equally love country music, like certain artists. So yeah, I'm just into really good music. I'm really into good music, and I don't really care about the genre as much.
Yeah, that's pretty cool, man.
So it is what it is, man. I just, you know, I'm a music junkie, but not, you know, like I said, I don't conform necessarily to, like, I'm a hip-hop dude, I represent for hip-hop. I was never like that. Even when I was in the thick of hip-hop, making it, playing it, DJing, loving it, but at the same time, never felt like I was just supposed to be there representing to the world or something like that.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Would you say that all the different kinds of genres of music that you've been involved in has definitely contributed to you and what music you create?
Absolutely. I mean, it can't not, you know, everything you get. Like, I'm the sort of dude that if I like a new artist or listen to a new style of music, very quickly I want to try it. I want to try doing it. You know, that's where the fan musician crossover gets blurry, you know, where you want to. And that's what's led me to all these different types of music. Like, if I get right into electronic music, just listening to it as a fan, then I want to tootoo around and make some beats. Mm. You know, if I listen to a new metal band, I want to pull out my bass or my guitar and play some heavy music. So it's, yeah, that's true. Everything that I've done lends to everything else. And when you're making hip-hop, especially, like, a lot of youngsters, especially, have grown up with computers and keyboards and technology, which is cool. But my roots in music is playing in bands. So I always had that as my foundation, even when I was playing with technology and machines and beat-making tools and stuff like that. I still thought like a musician. I still thought like a dude in a band in a room with the band members. That's how I listen to music, even electronic music. Yeah, so to answer your question, yes, it all influences everything else.
And on top of all of that, I know, because I've done a lot of work with you. I mean, we've made a lot of music together.
Yeah.
But because I've been with you for quite a long time and going to gigs and stuff, I also know that you're a very good businessman.
I don't know about that.
Oh, well, you know, like, in terms of you being your own business as a musician.
Well, thanks, man. I'll take the compliment. I don't know that I would
say that. I say that because I know every time that we've done a gig, we got paid. So if you get paid, then that means, you're a good businessman. Well,
yeah,
okay. Man.
Yeah, fair enough. I get it. If you value what you do, if you think, like, this is how it works to me. At least this is how my mind works. If I put in a lot of work, if you put in a lot of work to what you do, to be the best you can be, you turn up on time, you perform your heart out, you sound good, you know how to play your instrument or sing your song or whatever it is you're doing, that's worth something. To me, the money is not actually about the money. It's about putting a value, putting some sort of tangible value on what you do. And when you do that, in my experience, and it took years to work this out, if you do that, people will treat you better anyway.
Mm.
Because they realize, they're forced to realize that they're dealing with someone with a professional behavior.
Yes.
When you're not professional, you don't get treated professionally. I mean, it's not rocket science. It shouldn't have taken me this long to work it out, but it did.